Good morning, students. Today we are going to see one more important chapter, that is flow over the notches and gears. Before going to this chapter, let's see what is a notch and what is a gear and why we want to study this notches and gears. See, in the previous chapters we were studying about the venturi meters and orifice meters and pitot tube. What is that for? Those are all the devices which used to measure the rate of flow in a pipe. Okay, and pitot tube is a device which is used to measure the velocity in the pipe, and from that we will be able to find out the rate of flow. Anyway, ultimately they are used to measure the rate of flow, that is based upon the Bernoulli's equation. Now what we are going to do is, we are going to study about the notches and gears. What is the difference here is, what is a notch if you think of? This is a, once again a device which is used to measure the rate of flow only, but the rate of flow is going to be measured in case of a channel or a tank. Okay, so in case of your venturi meter or orifice meter, we have measured with the help of a, what is the rate of flow in a pipe, but notch is used to measure the rate of flow in a channel or a tank. Okay, so here what we are doing is, this notch is basically a metallic plate which will be kept in the tank or the channel, which is used to measure the rate of a flow. Okay, so it is an opening in the side of a tank or a small channel we used to normally place in the liquid surface in the tank or channel below the top of the opening. Suppose if you take a notch, how it will be is just like we are going to keep it. This is a tank, so the water is going to flow like this. So here we are going to place a notch. Okay, that's all. This is a notch, and this is said to be your nappy, and this is said to be your crest. So this is your kite hitch. Okay, so this is a metallic plate, or we can say a small type of opening which is placed in the channel or in a tank to measure the rate of flow. So what is the gear is? Gear is not a metallic plate, but it is a concrete or masonry structure which will be placed here, and this is also used to measure the rate of flow only in the channel or a tank. But what is that is, this notch, it is very smaller in size than that of a gear. Okay, notch is very smaller in size compared to that of a gear. What they do is, here they will have a masonry structure, okay, and over which your water will flow. So this is your gear. So this gear is made up of any concrete structures or of masonry structures that will be placed in an open channel in which the flow is occurring. Okay, so it is generally made up of a vertical wall with a sharp edge at the top, and it will be running all the way across the open channel. That is very important. Okay, so the gear will be running all way across the open channel. And here, what is nappy? This is otherwise said to be nappy or vein. What is this nappy or vein? From the figure itself, you could be able to understand the water or the sheet of water, okay, that is flowing through the notch or over the gear. It may be over the gear also. This sheet of water which is flowing over the gear or notch, that is said to be a nappy or vein. Then what is the crest? The bottom edge of the notch, or we can say at the top of the gear, whatever may be the case. Okay, what happens here, over which the water flows, that is known as the sill or crest. Okay, so the bottom edge of the notch or the top of this gear over which the water flows, that is said to be a gear. That is said to be a crest. So what we have seen here is, one is nappy or vein. Nappy or vein is a sheet of water that is flowing over this notch or the gear. In both the case, it is said to be nappy only. So what is crest is, at the bottom edge of this notch or at the top of this gear, the water, what is that flowing now? That is said to be a sill or crest. Okay, so the bottom edge of the notch or top of a gear over which the water flows, that is known as a sill or crest. Okay, so here we have different types of notches. We will see one by one. So this notches and gear, what is that? It is used to measure the rate of flow in a channel or in a tank. Okay, so based upon the different conditions, there are different types or classification of your notches. So what is the classification of notches? So how it is classified is, if you take notches, this notches is classified based upon two condition. One is you are based upon the shape of this. Okay, so based upon the shape it has been classified, and other one is based upon the effect of the sites. Okay, this effect of the sites will be on the nappy. Okay, so based upon this conditions, this notch are classified. One is based upon the shape, another one is effects of the sites on the nappy. So this will be classified once again into, based upon the shape, it is a rectangular notch, triangular notch, trapezoidal notch, and stepped notch. So this is based upon the shape, and based upon the effect of the sites on the nappy, it is being classified as notches with end contractions, notches without end contractions. So this is the general classification of notch. One is based upon the shape, another one is effect of the sites on the nappy. Similarly, the wears are also being classified. So here wears are also classified based upon the shape of the opening. Okay, as well as the effect of the sites on the nap, as well as the shape based on the crest. So here it has been classified as rectangular wear, triangular wear, as well as trapezoidal wear. So based upon the shape, the wears are classified as rectangular wear, triangular wear, and trapezoidal wear. And based upon the effects of the sites on the nappy, okay, or we can say on the emerging nappy, it is classified as wears with end contractions, and other one is wears without end contractions. Wears with end contractions and wears without end contractions. Then based upon the shape of the crest, it is being classified into short crested, broad crested, narrow crested, and ogee shaped. So here you could be able to see what are the different classification of the wears. Just we will recall, based upon the shape of the opening, it is classified as rectangular, triangular, as well as trapezoidal wears. So this trapezoidal wears is otherwise said to be cephalotic. Okay, and based upon the effects of the sites on the nap, it is classified as wears with end contractions and wears without end contractions. Similarly, shaped based on the shape on the crest, it is being classified as sharp crested, broad crested, narrow crested, as well as ogee shaped. Okay. Now what we are going to see is, we are going to see the discharge over this notch and wear. How to calculate the discharge over the wear and notch. Here that equation is same for both the cases, notch as well as wear. Only we have one derivation. So that will be applicable for both notch as well as the wears. So we are going to see a discharge over a rectangular notch. Discharge over a, we have three cases, one is rectangular notch and triangular notch and trapezoidal notch, what is given here syllabus. So discharge over a rectangular notch or wear. So this equation, as I said, it will be same for the case of both wear as well as the notch. So what we are going to do here is, I am just going to draw a diagram. So this is your notch, as I already said, we have drawn just now. So the water is going to flow like this, and this area is said to be a crest, and this area is said to be nappy. Okay. So now what is that? Is this height of water now? That is, take it as h. So what is h? It is the head of the water over the crest. So let h is head of the water over the crest. Okay, the same case will be there in case of your weir also. So weir also, what is that? Is this is just a weir masonry structure. So what is going to flow here? So this is your h. Once again, this is your crest. This is your nappy. Now what we are going to do is we are going to consider a small portion on this fluid element. Okay, which is at a distance of dh and a height h from the surface, and this length be length L. Okay, so we have found out that h is the head of crest, or I mean head of water over the crest. And next one is L. L is your length of your notch or weir. Okay, this is your length of your notch or weir. So we have known this. Now what we are going to do is we have considered, as I said, we have considered an elementary strip which is at a length of L and at a depth of dh. Okay, and which is at a height of, what is it, h meters from the free surface of the water. So what is the area of the strip? You can say it's very easy, length into breadth, am I right? So area of the strip is equal to L into dh. So we know the area of the strip. Now what is theoretical velocity? We have already seen using a beta tube, what is the theoretical velocity? That is equal to V equal to root 2 gh. Okay, so that is the theoretical velocity of water that is flowing through small strip. So it is root 2 gh. So what is discharge? Discharge I am not taking for the entire element, but I am taking for a small element. So let it be dq. So dq, discharge will be equal to cd, that is a coefficient of discharge if I am taking the actual discharge. So it is cd into area into velocity. So here what is my value of cd? That is to be found out for the case of your actual discharge. It is your coefficient of discharge. Okay, so now it will be discharge dq will be equal to cd into area is L into dh into velocity is root 2 gh. So this is only for a small strip. If you consider for an entire area, then here this will be, we have to integrate this equation. So with this equation, how will you integrate? With respect to h, because that is for the entire surface. Okay, so I am going to integrate this equation. Dq is equal to integral of cd into L into dh into root of 2gh, where this integration is from, as I said, from 0 to h. It is to the entire depth of 0 to h. Okay, so here this integral of dq is your q, and this are all, what is it, it's a constant. So what are all the constants here? I'm going to take it out. So what is that? Cd is a constant, L is not going to change with that of this h. Okay, and root 2g is also constant. So what will be my integral? Integral will be 0 to h of root h into dh. I am going to integrate with respect to this. Or how I can write this is cd into L into root 2g into integral of 0 to h to the power of 1 by 2 into dh. Okay, now I am going to integrate it. So how will you integrate this? Integrate of your h is increase the power by 1, divide by the same power. Okay, so cd into L into root 2 g, integral of h by 2 is h 1 by 2 plus 1, divide by 1 by 2 plus 1, 0 to h. These are the limits, 0 to h are the limits. So now how it will become? Cd into L into root 2 g, h to the power of 1 by 2 plus 1 is h to the power of 3 by 2 by 3 by 2 into 0 to h. Here the lower limit is 0, so that is being cancelled, only the upper limit we have to apply. So when we apply this upper limit, what does it happens? So this will become q is equal to CDL into root 2G. This 3 by 2 will become 2 by 3. So, I am giving as 2 by 3. Okay, and I am applying this limit, upper limit H. Okay, since it is upper limit, it will be only plus H to the power of 3 by 2. So, what is my equation now? Q equal to 2 by 3 CD into L into root 2G H to the power of 3 by 2. So, I rewrite this 2 by 3 CD into L into root 2G H to the power of 3 by 2. So, this is my equation for the rectangular notch or a rectangular wear. So, in this case, both these equations will be the same. Okay, for the case of a notch as well as for a wear. Now, we will go with the problem. Yes, guys. Here we are with two problems. One is find the discharge of water flowing over a rectangular notch of 2 meter length when the constant height over the notch is 300 mm. Take CD is equal to 0.60. So, what is given here? They are given you a rectangular notch because in future we will be seeing about the triangular notch as well as a trapezoidal notch. So, rectangular notch of length is given. So, first you note it out, what is the type of notch? It is a rectangular notch. So, the length is 2 meters. Okay. And when the constant height over the notch is 300 mm. So, height is also given. That is your capital H. That is 300 mm that is given. Okay. If you want, we can convert into meters. It is 0.3 meters. And CD is also given. So, what is asked? They ask you to find the discharge of water that is flowing over a rectangular notch. So, for this, what just now we have seen, right? What is the equation for that? What is it? 2 by 3 CD into L into root 2G of H to the power of 3 by 2. Okay, so the same formula we are going to use here. Discharge Q is equal to CD into L into root 2G of the same thing what we have discussed now. It is CD into L into root 2G into 2 by 3rd of H to the power of 3 by 2. Okay, this is the equation we got right now. It is 2 by 3 CD into L into root 2G into H to the power of 3 by 2. So, what is that CD value I have known? L value I have known. G is 9.81. We know that it is acceleration due to gravity. And H is also given. So, everything is in the same unit. 2 meters, 0.3 meters. Just substitute here. 2 by 3 of CD is 0.6 into L is 2 meters. Please here give it only in terms of meters. Okay, 9.81 meters per second square into H is 0.3 to the power of 3 by 2 or we can say it is 1.5. Both are same. 3 by 2 can be written as 1.5 also. No issues. So, just we are merely substituting in this equation and we can get the value of your discharge. Just when you solve this, you will be getting the value as 0.582. Since everything is in meter, the discharge is in meter cube per second. So, this is a very simple problem. Just by mere substitution, we have got the answer. Now, we have one more interesting problem here that we will check it out. What is the difference between this problem and that problem? Because all the problems will not be like same throughout for any fluid mechanics. Okay, small changes will be there from problem to problem. So, that's why I always used to say that please understand the problem in deep, then try to do it up. Here, determine the height of a rectangular wear. This is not of notch, it is a wear. Of length 6 meter to be built across a rectangular channel. So, what is the difference between wear and a notch? Usually, notch will be smaller than wear. And wear is made up of masonry structures. Okay, but notch is made up of only metallic plates. So, they ask you to find out the height of the wear they are going to construct up. Whereas the length is 6 meter, okay, across a rectangular channel is that we are going to construct this. So, the maximum depth of water on the upstream side of the wear is, maximum depth of the water is given, it is 1.8 meter. And discharge is given, it is 2000 liter per second. Take CD is equal to 0.6 and neglect the H contraction. So, N contractions has to be neglected. So, what are the details given here? So, length is given 6 meters and discharge is given 2000 liter per second. So since it is liter per second, please convert it into meter cubes. Okay, how it did? Divide by 1000. So it is 2 meter cube per second. So that also you have got. CD is given 0.6. And the maximum depth of water on the upstream side of the weir, that is given here. So what is the maximum depth of the water on the upstream side of the weir? So that will be your 1.8 meter. So let it be H1. So I will show you how it is that. See, I am going to construct a weir here. Okay, and this is a rectangular channel over which my water flows like this. So the weir I am going to construct here. And this is my crest. Okay, so this is my crest area. So till this height, let this be your height H. Okay, and this height, the total height is like the height of H1. Okay, total height is your height of H1. What they ask you is, they ask you to find out the height of the rectangular weir. So this height is asked, which is your H2. So from this, what you could understand is, H1 is equal to, that is your total depth of your channel. Okay, so total depth of the channel is height over the weir or height over the crest, height of water over the crest plus the height of your weir. Okay, so this together, height of fluid, we can say height of fluid over the crest, this one plus this one, that is your height of the weir. Now, what is given in your problem is this value H1 is given where it is the maximum depth of water on the upstream side of the weir. So, that means the water is moving from here to here. So, this is said to be the upstream side where it starts. Okay. And where it's going to reach, that is your downstream side. Okay. So, in the upstream side means the maximum depth is here. Entire depth of the weir is 1.8 meters. Okay. So now we have to calculate what is the value of H2. Now what is that? First we have to find out what is H. Okay, if we know that H only, what is that? It is H plus H2. Am I right? So H plus H2. If I know this H only, I will be able to find out. H1 is given, I will be able to find out the H2. So for finding out this H, we know the equation for a rectangular weir or a rectangular notch, both are same. Just now we have written what is the equation. Discharge is equal to 2 by 3 CD L into root 2G of H to the power of 3 by 2. Okay, so this is the equation. CD is known, L is known, G is known, Q is also given. We have converted in terms of meter cube per second. So check everything is in same unit. This we can substitute here. So how is Q is 2 meter cube per second. 2 is equal to 2 by 3 into CD is 0.6 into length is 6 meter into root of 2 into 9.81. If it is 981, it is centimeter per, centimeter per meter second square. But this is meter per second square because everything is in meter. So we are giving here Newton, G acceleration due to gravity is also meter. Okay, so on H is your unknown. So, I have no given all the values. Only thing is my H is, which is the unknown. So, what when I am getting this, how it will be? H to the power of 3 by 2 is equal to 2 divided by this value. So, this value when you solve it, it is 10.623. Or we can write this is H, when this 3 by 2 is coming to that side, it is of 2 by 3. It is ulta. So, 2 divided by 10.623 to the power of 2 by 3. Okay, so when you solve this, what is the value of H I am giving is 0.328 meters. My question is not the height of fluid over the crest. Okay, this H is my height of the fluid over the crest. That is not my question. So what is my question? I have to find out what is the height of the weir. So height of the weir is total depth minus this one, height of the fluid over the crest. You will be able to find out what is the height of the weir. So just I am going to substitute in this equation and I am going to find out what is the height of the weir. So as I know that the total depth is total depth of water in the channel. Okay, total depth of your channel or water in the channel is equal to H1 is equal to H plus H2. Okay, H1 is 1.8 meters, H is 0.328 meters plus H2. where my H2 value is this minus this, so 1.8 minus 0.328. So how much is that? That is my value of my H2. What is the H2? It is the height of the weir. So height of the weir is equal to H2 is equal to total depth minus your depth over the crest. Okay, where the height of the water above the crest. So what it will be there? It is when you subtract this, you are getting the answer of 1.472 meter. So what is the difference here? We have seen in the first problem, we have just substituted the value in the equation and we have completed. But in the second problem, what is it? They have given a different thing. They ask you to find out the depth of the weir. They ask you to find out the depth of the weir, or we can say the height of the weir. So from the total channel height, we have found out the height of the crest. Then we have found out what is the height of your weir. Now we will see with one more problem. Yes, next. So now we have one more problem with us. What is that is? The head of water over a rectangular notch is 900 mm. So the head is given over a rectangular notch. Okay. So this is your notch. And this is your crest. This is your nappy. Alright. So this is your crest. The head of the notch, or what we say, the head of water over the notch. Okay, this is given. Your H is given. And the discharge is also given. So H is how much? 900 mm. So we have to convert this in terms of meters. So what we know? 1 meter is equal to 1000 mm. So if you want to convert a meter into mm, we will multiply with 1000. If you want to convert mm into meter, then it is 10 to the power of minus 3. Okay. So this will be 900 into 10 to the power of minus 3 meter, or we can say that 0.9 meter. So this is my height of the water over the rectangular notch. And discharge is also given here. Discharge is how much? Q is 300 liter per second. See, in some problem they will be given even per instead of second they will be giving you minute. Okay, so we have to convert, check whether what is the unit given correctly, and we have to convert to the respective unit. So here what is the discharge that is given is 300 liter per second, but I don't want to have it in liter, I want to convert in terms of meter cube. So what is that is 1 liter is equal to 1 by 1000 of meter cube. So what I am doing is I am going to divide this by 1000. So it is 300 by 1000. The liter will be changed into meter cube per second, or we can say it is 0.3 meter cube per second. So my discharge is also given. Now what is that is, they have given you the value of CD is also. CD is 0.62, and they ask you to find out the length of the notch. So what we have seen in the first problem, we have just worked out and we have got the value of your discharge. And in the second problem, we have found out the height, H, of the weir. Okay, so now in the third problem, what is the twist they have given here is, they ask you to find out the length of this notch. Okay, the formula is same what we have derived for your rectangular notch. Just now we have derived that equation also. So that formula or that equation is same, but only thing is, which question they have asked or how it is being twisted, you have to understand. So here, in case of your discharge over a rectangular notch, okay, Q will be 2 by 3 CD into L into root 2G into H to the power of 3 by 2. This is our equation. Am I right? So here what is given? CD value is given in the problem. L value is asked. We have to find out the length of the notch. And G value is also, we know it is acceleration due to gravity. It's 9.81. Probably if every unit is in meters. Okay. And H is also here given 0.9 meter. So only thing is, we are going to substitute in this equation. So it is 2 by 3. CD value is 0.62 into length is your unknown into root 2 into G is 9.81 into H is 0.9 to the power of 3 by 2. So I have just substituted all my values in here, and Q value we have to substitute. Q is just now we have found out it is 0.3 meter cube per second. So just check whether once all the units are in the same. Okay, so here CD doesn't have any unit since it's a coefficient. Length we have to find it out. 9.81 is meter per second square. It's acceleration due to gravity, na. So it is change of velocity to time taken. Okay, and velocity we know it is meter per second. So this is it is in meters. Since it's a height, we have converted into meters. It was given as 900 mm. We have converted into meters. So we have substituted all these values here. Now what we are going to do is we have to convert these things and we have to get the value of length. So when we get the length, it is coming as 0.192 meters. But this length is very small. So what we are doing is we are converting in terms of meters. So once again, when we are converting meters into mm, what happens is 1 meter is equal to 1000 mm. Okay. So previous time we have converted millimeter to meter. Now what we are going to do is we are going to convert the meter into mm. So what we are doing is 1 meter is 1000 mm. So 0.19 meter is how much? L is equal to 0.192 into 1000. This is in mm. So we can say L is equal to how much? 303. So 192 mm. Okay guys, so what we have seen so far, we have seen what are the what is a notch, what is a weir, what is a nappy and what is a crest. All those definitions we have seen, and apart from that we have seen what are the different types of notches, what are the different types of weirs, and out of that we have derived an equation for a rectangular notch, and based upon that equation we have solved some 3 problems. So in our next video, we will go with that of your triangular notch. Thank you guys.